Darwin. So I'm sure we all heard of Darwin. You know, he wrote that book, The Origin of Species, back in the 1850s. And, you know, he really came up with a theory of natural selection and evolution. And kind of what led him to this theory was that he had a voyage on the HMS Beagle. And this voyage, you know, at the time, actually, he was very lucky. He actually got to circumnavigate the globe. And, you know, he got to study a lot of different, you know, biological systems and those kind of things. But one of the main things that he actually gathered from that was the Galapagos Island finches. And these birds, he noticed they varied in their beak size. So, for instance, you know, he would find a bird that had like a beak kind of like, you know, like sharper and longer. And these were, you know, mainly for eating cacti. And then he would find, you know, another bird on a you know, the same island or a different island would have, you know, kind of a beak like this, you know, more for eating insects, you know, and flies and these kind of things. And then he'd find birds with these big hunkering beaks, you know, that he found, you know, nibbled on seeds and those kind of things. So he would see that, you know, well, wow, there are all these different types of birds, yet they all have these different adaptations, you know, to their environment, to their food, and, you know, the food accessibility that they have in each environment. And so, you know, Darwin, he observed several things on for selection-wise, and one of those things was that, you know, all the traits are heritable, meaning that, you know, traits are passed down from parent to offspring. The other important, you know, observation is that not all the offspring survive. This means that, you know, a habitat may not have enough resources to support all the offspring. And, you know, going co in hand with that is that individuals breed at high rates. And if these individuals are breeding at such a high rate, you know, the environment just can't support that many offspring. And the fourth observation that he has is that, you know, individuals vary in their traits, meaning that, you know, all individuals, they differ in some way or another from each other. And what he kind of inferred from these four observations that he had was that, you know, the individuals that had more favorable traits for their environment tended to reproduce and survive at higher rates than those that did not have the favorable traits. And these favorable traits tended to accumulate over generations and over periods of time. Oh yes, and also another very important thing to get off natural selection is that the individual himself or herself does not actually evolve. It's actually the population that evolves. So when we're talking about natural selection, we're talking that it you know, we're talking about, you know, individuals not evolving, but the actual population of it evolving. So for instance, say we had, you know, a group of, I don't know, like black insects, you know, black and gray insects. And these black insects, you know, say there was like say there's like four of them here, and these guys are all black, and then we had like one white one there, but then slowly over time, the black ones tended to not survive for I don't know which reason, but as you can see, the individual himself is not actually evolving. It's the whole population that's evolving towards the trend of white beetles.